Have a nice day, everyone. In this video, I will speak about the confusion between the aircraft technical logbook and the aircraft logbook. There is a difference between them. Okay? The aircraft technical logbook is the last known status of the aircraft in terms of its current flying hours, flight cycles, current maintenance status, including the carrying of any acceptable deferred defects or B snag or open item that may affect the aircraft and operation, the fuel and fluid, such as hydraulic, oil, potable water status, or the aircraft at the point of departure. But the aircraft logbook, this like engine logbook, propeller logbook, APU logbooks. So for aircraft logbook, the aircraft logbook is the record in which all data concerning the aircraft is recorded. Information gathered in this log is used to determine the aircraft condition, date of manufacture, MSN manufacturer serial number for Airbus, line number for Boeing, and inspections time on airframe engine propeller APU. Okay, so the logbook here also recorded the EDs and service bulletin compliance in this aircraft or this item. This is one page of the technical logbook of the aircraft. I will split this paper into parts. This is parts and other parts, other parts, other parts, other parts. Okay, I will take every parts and details. This is the first one. Here, the log sheet or log page serial number here of this book. Here, the form number. The form number is the number of the form and the X position or GMM of the airline. Here, issue date of this form, okay? This area for the airline name and its logo here. Here, the aircraft type, Boeing or Airbus, or so and so. Here, aircraft log, technical logbook. Here, the notes. All enters should be in block letter, all terms, all times to be recorded in GMT, Greenwich Mean Time, okay, in English and capital letter. Here, the aircraft registration. Here, SU for Egypt, but your country, these letters may be different. And here, the registration of the aircraft. Here, the date of flight. Here, the flight number from the departure airport here. And here, the arrival airport here. Number of landing. Why number of landing, not one? Maybe this aircraft make training for pilots, so maybe that chance go 3 or 4 cycles or legs. Okay. Also, I suggest to put here if this flight number it ops or no. Okay, but it's not here. This is the other parts for the time, the look time, the kind. This is hours and minutes. Hours, separate column, and the minute in other column. Landed. Landed means the aircraft in flight, then descend and touch the ground. This is landed time. Airborne means the aircraft left the ground, means takeoff. This is takeoff time. The sector time is the difference between the two times here. So the landed minus airborne, you will get the sector time. This is the flight time. Time before, put it here, add the sector time to the to time before, you will get total time. This is the total time since it checked. Okay, since it checked, to calculate when you make your the coming a check or C check, so and so. Checks off before towing, you make check off. Then checks on when the aircraft stop on the gate or on the stand. Okay, you put the check. Why I need this? This to calculate the block hours. The block hours, I needed it in financial for lease. I calculate the minimum hour, minimum block hours per month. So I will pay for lease here. But here, this is for checks. The other parts here for the defects on the aircraft. The number of defect here. Here, the defect, the pilot, when he finds anything during the flight, he put it here, he write here. This is the pilot reports here. And here, the rectification of the maintenance engineer or maintenance technical, put it the action taken here according to maintenance manual reference or MEL reference, so and so. If any replacement here, you put the part number on and part number off, serial number on, serial number off here. Sometimes the maintenance engineer will find during make a round check up for aircraft without the pilot reports. So he write here, maintenance report here, okay? Here, the signature and the stamp of the maintenance personnel. Oh, here, the maintenance engineer here. Here, takeoff EPR. This is for the engine monitor, engine condition monitor. Flexible takeoff also to save fuel. Here, captain name and the signature here. Okay. Here, I don't need this, because in this in another part, okay? Here, the servicing here, the fuel servicing, the tank, left tank, center tank, right tank, and this is the total. Here, the arrival quantity. Here, the left, up left, refueling here, the quantity. Here, the departure quantity. Okay. Here is the hydraulic servicing. The system name, yellow, blue, green. This is for Airbus. But in Boeing, maybe other systems. Okay. And this is the quantity here. Here, the company of the fueling and receipt number, the invoice number here. Okay. We will go to other parts. This is tire pressure. Main left, main right, nose, two here, two wheels. Two wheels, two wheels, according your number of wheels. Oil servicing, okay. Engine, port, starboard, or left and right, or one and two, and APU. Here, arrival, here, up left, which added the quantity with a bent, with bent. Not quart, not a liter, not gallon. Here, the departure quantity. Other parts here. The checks complied. The signature, authorization, and date, and time, and sign. Okay. Check A, weekly check, daily check, pre-flight check, okay, or transit check. This is statement that you will follow the, here must be the local civil aviation, not Egyptian, but here, this example for Egypt, okay, because SU. Here, captain name and time sign. This is the agreement between the pilot and the maintenance engineer. Now he accept and take the aircraft, okay. After that, you will take a copy from this page to the maintenance engineer. Okay? Thank you very much. Before that, I am waiting your comments and your suggestion. Thank you very much and goodbye.